Tony Doherty here for NPC News Online with four-time Mr. Olympia, Phil Heath. What's that you got, Phil?
Man.
You love your bling, but this is crazy. Look
this
at that.
This is amazing. I had no idea that they were going to 18 karat gold. Are you kidding me?
That's I mean,
the Sandow is one thing, you know, but to have it, this one's obviously special. I mean, no other Mr. Olympia has had a 50th. So this is definitely, I don't know where I'm going to put this one, you know, because I was...
I'm going to do a special case for that.
This has to go somewhere really special.
Glass case sure. With a light set in it and everything, with it, maybe a dimmer switch.
Something like that. May have to buy a new house.
Put it down, man, because you're
it's a little heavy,
actually. It looks a little heavy, and you've just got off stage. So thanks for coming to NPC News Online. Do what's become a real regular interview for us.
Yeah.
Phil, a lot of pressure for you going into this contest. A lot of talk and stuff going around here and there, but you remain dignified. You got your job done. How satisfying was your win tonight?
Wow, this one was very satisfying just because of the fact that it was a team effort. You know, it didn't just come from me. It came from my family, came from my friends who were pretty much like family, and then obviously my sponsors, and then also the fans. I mean, the support that I've had this year has been like no other. You know, this year has been filled with, you know, ups and downs, but a lot of hard work and a lot of dedication, especially with me, you know, actually starting my own, you know, supplement line too in the middle of prep. Just having those people around me that support me and love me, you know, my training was great. You know, my trainer, Hani Rambod, you know, he did a great job. You know, my chiropractor. There's so many people I love to thank. I mean, it was a Team Heath effort.
It really was. But Heath became a brand this year. So it wasn't just Phil training for the Olympia. You got this new supplement company. You know, I worried about you as your friend. I'm like, how are you going to get all this done? I know how crazy it is when you get busy and you miss meals and you miss sleep and all sorts of stuff. But I know you got Hani in your corner making sure you eat, your wife, your whole family, everyone just making sure you stay on track, your restaurants in Colorado, they've got the Phil specials. So it really is a massive team effort.
Yeah, absolutely. And to know that you know, bodybuilding is yet still a business as well off the stage, and you know, I was able to put myself with some incredible talent, some incredibly talented people that believe in the same things I believe, which is, you know, having the best of everything, you know, working the hardest, harder than anyone else, and to be willing to share those, you know, perspectives onto the world. And you know, I just feel like even with my supplement company, and then also just with my trainer and everything, I mean, it was a great day. It was a great week. It wasn't easy. You know, I'm going against the best in the world. I was pushed to the edge.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, with it being a 2-day show, it's always tough. And you know, Friday night was really tough. I was able to bring it in, you know, and stay tight and full, you know, like I normally do on Saturday night. And I definitely feel that that made the difference. And having the experience, too, I think helped me along the way.
You got better at that, and you're definitely better tonight. Now, I know that you push yourself along, but all these other guys that are nipping at your heels, you know, Kai Green, Sean Roden, back in the top three. I mean, you know, he didn't do anything wrong last year. Just Wolf got better.
Yeah.
But that really hurt him. And I know at the Arnold this year, he said, that ain't going to happen again. And he probably took advantage of you and Kai being the favorites, just out of the limelight.
Well,
put on about 20 pounds and got in the same condition.
He did exactly that. I mean, you know, my hat goes off to Sean. I mean, because I remember speaking with him after the Arnold Classic, and he was really down. And it's always hard because we all pretty much get along, you know, and it's hard to root for one another sometimes, because when you're not competing, and I'm seeing Wolf and I get along with him, I see Sean get along with him, and I see him go 1-2, it's like coin flip for me. And to see one excited and one down, what do you tell him? And all I told him was like, hey, look, you know, I've never won an Arnold Classic Columbus. You know, you just never know. And all you have to do is just continue to, you know, try harder, and your time will come. And look, he got third place. This was an amazing lineup. A lot of guys looked fantastic. They knew it was at stake.
Yeah.
Everybody wanted to bring it with the 50th Mr. Olympia.
Everyone bought it.
And he gets to go into, you know, to his next shows. I believe he's doing the Arnold Spain and whatnot. And he has a really good opportunity to create some massive noise going into 2015. So, I mean, the guy's no joke. I mean, I respect him along with all the other amazing guys.
Yeah, look, and obviously you and Kai went at it all weekend. But you know what was a great moment for the sport? When it was done and your name was announced, he was the first person to come over, shake your hand, and I thought he was gracious in defeat and quite sincere.
I think so. I mean, I think, look, I mean, at the end of the day, you know, I'm a guy that's preventing him that one spot up. And it's like Boston Red Sox and the Yankees. You know, it really is. And Detroit Pistons and Chicago Bulls.
I mean, after the pre-judging last night, looked online. You two really divide the fans.
And you know what? In a way, that's great because of the fact that fans are here. They want to see not a one-sided show. They want to see two separate people from separate everything getting after it. You know,
and it's
just incredible.
And despite it being, I guess, personal at times, a little stressful for you both, it was really, really entertaining. I think really gave the weekend even more of a feel and probably made that win feel even more special.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, I dedicated this one to my late father, Don Heath, and I just wanted to make sure that I, you know, fulfill my promise into just working hard. Just work as hard as I can, you know, and try to get another win. And, you know, I was able to do that. And, you know, when you bring up, you know, reasons what you know, motivates you and you have, you know, hardship, that should motivate you to do better. No matter what it is, we all have hardship. And it's not about, you know, using them as whining tools or anything like that. It's more for motivation. It's more to also let people know that I'm human. And just like you, we all go through things, but I was able to use it for something positive, and bodybuilding allowed me an outlet. And that was very, very special to me that I had an outlet. I didn't go out and drinking beers and acting a fool. I had the gym. I had the gym to go let out my frustrations, and that put it into my body to where I could be up on stage and then win again.
Well, I think through the hardships your family has been the last couple of years, you've probably learned to tap into that and really turn into something productive and positive, and then to really motivate all those around you to lift and do what they do.
I think that's essentially what being the gift really is that I along with everyone else has a gift, and it's upon them to find it, be passionate about it, cultivate that sucker, and then when called upon, give it your all, and then make sure that it resonates throughout everyone else. Give your perspectives positively to other people. Try to help somebody with this. I know my story is going to help one person out there. That's my job right now. I've already won 4 Sandals now. It feels freaking amazing. But my job continuously is to raise the sport of bodybuilding to greater heights and be a part of this amazing journey. I mean, a lot of people thought bodybuilding was dead. It's not dead at all. No. This is the biggest spectacle I've ever seen, you know, in all sports I've been around. So this is incredible.
It was incredible, and it really was. Now, Phil, you've done something special, something not many men have ever achieved. You'll go down as one of the greats in bodybuilding. You've got fans all over the world. I know all your family, everyone's waiting to interview you. So let's just give one last message to your fans out there that couldn't be here tonight. They're watching around the world on NPC News Online.
All you guys watching NPC News Online, thank you so much for tuning in. My man Tony Doherty, along with the other guys, you know, working here, have done an amazing job for you guys. They do it for you. You know, just like myself, we try to give you guys as much perspective as possible, much motivation and inspiration. Be sure to log on to NPC News Online. That was actually the same organization that I turned pro at when in the 2005 Mr. USA contest. Want to be Mr. Olympia? Go through NPC and make sure you support not just myself, but the sport of bodybuilding and health and fitness. Thank you guys for tuning in. God bless and good night.
Phil Heath, a great champion on and off the stage. We're out.